Hello children, today let's continue our revision of chapter 2, Microorganisms, Friend and Foe. Let's revise some MCQ questions and then all the possible questions from this chapter. First, microorganisms exhibiting the characteristics of living and non-living organisms are known as. We have to choose the correct option from the given options. Bacteria, virus, algae, fungi. These are all different groups of microorganisms. Which group of microorganisms shows both the characteristics of living and non-living organisms? So here, virus is which shows both the characteristics of living and non-living organisms, because virus, once if they enter the host organism, then only they can reproduce, isn't it? So that is why it has both the characteristics of living and non-living organisms. So the correct option is virus. Next question, a person bitten by a dog gets dash. This a general one. A person bitten by dog gets a disease called rabies. So the correct option is D, rabies. Then amoebic dysentery is transmitted by sneezing, using contaminated water, direct contact, wound. It is transmitted by contaminated water. So the correct option is B. Next one. Anthrax in cattle is caused by fungi, virus, bacteria, algae. Anthrax in cattle is caused by bacteria. So the correct option is C. Smut of rice is caused by, it is a plant disease, that is, smut of rice is caused by virus, protozoa, fungi, bacteria. Plant disease is caused by fungi. So the correct option is C. Next one, wheat, maize and oats are preserved by using sugar and salt, pasteurization, drying, using chemical preservatives. This all grains, they are first mainly preserved by drying, isn't it? So wheat, maize and oats are preserved by drying. So the correct option is C. Next one, jams and jellies are preserved by drying, using chemical preservatives, using acetic acid, using heat and cold treatments. Jams and jellies, they are preserved by using chemical preservatives. So the correct option is B. Next one, pasteurization is a method used for preserving milk, jams, pickles, grains. What is pasteurization? When milk is boiled at very high temperature and then cold suddenly, isn't it? That is called pasteurization. So here, pasteurization is a method, is the method used for preserving milk. So the correct option is A. Fermentation is a process used for making curd, cheese, idlis, chapatis. Which one? Fermentation is a process used for fermented food item here, which one it is? Idlis, isn't it? So fermentation is a process used for making idlis. So children, this way you have to learn all the plant and animal diseases which are caused by different microorganisms. Now let's continue some discussing about some brief answer and answering one sentence, etc. How can we control the spread of malaria or dengue? For control spread of malaria and dengue, what are the precautions we have to take and what are the preventive measures we have to take? First one, we know that all mosquitoes breed in water. Hence, we have to keep our surroundings clean and dry, because mosquito breed only in stagnant water, isn't it? So if we keep our surroundings clean and dry, this prevent mosquitoes from breeding. Then we should not allow water to collect in coolers, flower pots, etc. Then we should wear full sleeves, shirts in the evening at night, and we can also use mosquito repellent creams and mosquito nets. So in this way we can control the spread of malaria or dengue. So these points will be given in the form of will be given, and options will be given in different way. You have to go through the both the options thoroughly, and you have to select which are the points given in which option is suitable for the given question. So you go through all the points thoroughly, read, and then you have to choose the correct option. How does food become poison? So microorganisms that grow in our food, they produce toxic substances. This makes the food poisonous, causing serious illness and even death. Next question, what will happen if yeast powder is put in sugar solution and kept for few hours? Name the process. So when yeast powder is put in sugar solution and kept for few hours, fermentation takes place, isn't it? So the what is name the process? It is fermentation. And what is fermentation? The conversion of sugar into alcohol by yeast is called as fermentation. Next one, how can you prevent the spread of communicable diseases? Communicable diseases are spread from one person to other person, isn't it? So how can we prevent the spread of communicable diseases? To avoid contact with infected person. First point, we should avoid contact with infected person. For that, what we have to do? We should keep distance from infected person. Nowadays, we tell, no, maintain social distancing, isn't it? So we should keep distance from infected persons. In this way, we can prevent the spread of communicable diseases. Next one, give the methods of prevention of cholera. Cholera is prevented by, can be prevented by, first one, vaccination. We have to maintain good personal hygiene and consume properly cooked food and drinking boiled water. Not that it is spread by contaminated water, isn't it? So consuming properly cooked food and drinking boiled water. In this way, we can prevent cholera. How does a vaccine act? Vaccine, it acts by making body's immune system to produce antibodies against the disease causing microbe in the vaccine. So vaccine itself consists of microbe, isn't it? When the vaccine is injected, when the microorganism is injected in our body, our immune system produces suitable antibodies, and these antibodies attack and destroy the weakened microbes that enters in our body. So in this way, vaccine act. First, vaccine, it makes our body immune system to produce suitable antibodies against the disease causing microbe, and the antibodies will attack and destroy the weakened microbes which enter in our body. In this way, vaccine acts. Next one, how is common cold spread? We know that common cold, how it spread. When a person suffering from common cold, when he sneezes or when he coughs, fine droplets of moisture, carrying thousands of viruses causing common cold are spread in the air. The viruses may enter the body of a healthy person while breathing. So how it mainly spread through air. But when a person suffering from common cold, when he sneezes, coughs, or when he speaks, the droplets of moisture which carry thousands of virus which causes common cold will spread in air, and the healthy person, when he inhales this air, viruses enter into his or her body and affect, and they also contract common cold. In this way, common cold spread. What will happen if you take antibiotics when it is not needed? So if we take antibiotics when it is not needed, we help our body, bacteria in our body to develop resistance to them. Next time when we fall ill and need these antibiotics, it would be less effective. So antibiotics should be taken whenever it is necessary, and it should be taken at proper proper dose which is advised prescribed by doctor. Got it? And then how are bacteria beneficial for us? First, bacteria are useful for us in different ways. First, nitrogen fixing bacteria, it increases the fertility of the soil. Then bacteria lactobacillus, it is used to form convert milk into curd. Then it is used to make alcohol, and also decomposing bacteria, they can decompose the dead organic matter. So these are different uses of bacteria. Next one, let us revise some answer in one sentence question. Name one plant disease caused by fungi and its mode of transmission. Here we have to write the name of the disease caused by fungus and the mode of transmission, how it transmit, how it spread from spread to others. Got that? Here plant disease, so how it is being transmitted, spread. Plant disease caused by fungi is rust of wheat. This is very important, rust of wheat, and it is transmitted through air and seeds. See in your textbook that table is given of different plant disease caused by different microorganism and mode of transmission, as well as the animal diseases. So this you have to learn thoroughly. So name of plant disease caused by fungi is rust of wheat. Transmission, mode of transmission is air and seeds. Next, what is meant by food poisoning? Food poisoning is caused by consuming the food that has been spoiled by some microorganisms, or microorganisms which produces toxic substance makes the food poison. And when this food is eaten, we call that as food poisoning, which is very dangerous. Sometimes it may lead to death also. Next, what are preservatives, chemicals like salt, sugar, etc., which used to check, arrest the growth of microorganisms are called as preservatives. And some chemical preservatives, name of the chemicals, we have learned that sodium metabisulfate, sodium benzoate, and all these are all some chemical preservatives, isn't it, other than salt, sugar, which are used to check. Check here means arrest or stop the growth of microorganisms, and these chemicals are called preservatives. Next, name one plant disease caused by bacteria and its mode of transmission. First we have discussed about fungi, now bacteria. Citrus canker is caused by bacteria and mode of transmission is air. Next, name one plant disease transmitted by insects and caused by virus. Both transmitted by insects and virus, it is yellow vein mosaic of Bindi. Name the plant disease again caused by fungi and mode of transmission. We know that rust of wheat and air, and mode of transmission is air and seeds. Got it? This question got repeated. Fungi is rust of wheat and mode of transmission is air and seed. So this way you should know name plant disease caused by fungi, bacteria, virus, and all, and as well as mode of transmission. Okay, children, that's all for this session. We will continue the revision of the same chapter in the next session. You read the chapter thoroughly. Thank you.